The most asked question that I get besides, hey, Chaos, when are you doing another COD History Top 10 is, Chaos or Jimmy, how do I get started on YouTube? Chaos, is it too late to start a YouTube gaming channel? Well, as you guys know, I've been in the YouTube gaming sphere for a long time, over a decade. And every few years, I like to do a little guide video or a couple videos because things on YouTube change a lot. And the advice I gave a year or two ago may not be the same advice that I give today. Today, I want to focus on gaming channels. I want to have a real heart-to-heart with you guys and share my knowledge and see if I can help you get your first 1,000 subs on a YouTube gaming channel in 2020. So you let me know in the comments what you think has worked well for you and your channel. If you've started one recently, drop a like, and if you have a channel, put it in the comment section as well. So today, I'm going to help you guys get your first 1,000 subs on your gaming channel. I see a ton of you are watching and enjoying the content on the channel, but you're not subscribed. Take a second, hit that sub button, turn on those notifications, and let's get the Team Chaos subscriber percentage up into the 30s. So the very first thing you need to do if you're really serious about growing on YouTube is learn to make a decent thumbnail. You heard me. That's right. The old days are over, my friends. No longer can you put together a good video and just use a thumbnail that has no thought or process put into it to get things moving. With how over-edited most thumbnails are now, people just aren't going to click on a crap thumbnail. They're not. It's true. Thankfully, thumbnails are also easier than ever to make, and you should be able to teach yourself all the basics in an hour or less. You need to make sure your thumbnails make it clear what the video is about and what the game you're playing is also about. What makes it unique? Red arrows and circles don't do it anymore because that's what everybody did for like 2 years. Now, it's all about finding the style that fits your channel. If you're a commentary channel like me, make it more subtle and precise, more clean. If you're doing gameplays or stream highlights, make it more active and bright and exciting like what Tim the Tatman does with his thumbnails. But the actual thumbnail isn't the only important thing. You also need to be sure that your thumbnail style remains consistent throughout your entire channel. If you look through all the uploads of any successful YouTuber, you'll see that their thumbnail style is consistent. The way you do your thumbnails is basically how you market yourself and the way you present your own brand. Just pretend you're walking in Walmart and you're walking up to the checkout and you want a candy bar. All those candy bars are strategically put in a certain place for a reason, because they want you to grab theirs first. It's the same when you're shopping content on YouTube. You're scrolling through and you're going to grab the thumbnail that jumps out to you. Now, I mean, I change thumbnail styles every few months and then I'll stick with that style until I think it's time to change again. But I always try to keep things uniform and like they're connected to one another, because they are. So figure out a thumbnail style you like, stick with it. There's nothing wrong with upgrading it or changing it around from time to time. Don't throw a screenshot of gameplay up there with a red arrow and think that you're going to blow up and get all these views and go viral. It does not cut it anymore. So let's stick with keeping things uniform. That's very, very important. You need to figure out what you want to do and stick with it. And you guys know me. I do top 10 videos and Call of Duty commentaries on this channel. That's my thing. What's your thing? And trust me, I'm not perfect. I've tried to veer away from that path numerous times on this channel just to be redirected to it, because that is the core audience that was built for this channel. In order to stand out on YouTube today, and if you're really serious about growing in 2020, you have to have a thing. People have said that you need to find a completely unique avenue for yourself, but honestly, I don't agree with that. I don't. There are tons of different genres of videos on YouTube, just like how there are different genres of music. You don't have to reinvent the wheel in order to gain an audience. You just have to be really good at maintaining that wheel once you figure out what your wheel is, and that's the key. What is your wheel? Are you following what I'm saying here? For example, look at Drifter and the Exclusive Ace in the Call of Duty community. Very similar channels, very similar content, but both on top of their game because they have a unique approach to the same style of content. Sticking with Call of Duty channels, look at Fortunate and Go619. Extremely similar content, but two very different personalities while presenting that content, and they put their own twist on it. You don't have to do something completely innovative, but you do need to give viewers a reason to keep coming back to you, and that could be something as simple as your personality or your sense of humor or your editing style. Drifter and Ace can make a video with the exact same script, but you would still immediately be able to tell whose video belonged to which creator. I make top 10 videos, but so do a million other channels, and we all do our own thing with them. So I guess my point here is, find something you want to do, but make sure you're at least doing something unique with it. Put your little twist on it to make it stand out and make people recognize, hey, that's his video. Now, with all that being said, you need to be doing something you actually enjoy doing. I think we all know the feeling of watching a YouTuber make a video that you can tell they don't actually care about making. Or maybe you're watching a streamer play a game that you can tell they don't want to play this game. Now, this hurts the content because unless you're an absolute pro at this stuff, the audience will be able to tell if your heart is actually in the content that you're making. Plus, when you're not enjoying yourself, you can't bring your A game to the content. Whereas if you were making content you really liked and you were really passionate about it, it's not only going to make the process a lot more fun, but it's going to make the end product way more enjoyable to watch because that passion is infectious, my friends. Even if you want to do something that's a bit niche, it never hurts to try. In fact, I would encourage you to try to make niche content if that's what you want, because if you're trying to compete with the big boys right now or big girls or whoever, you're not going to have much success. It is a saturated platform. That's just the truth. Make sure you're making content you actually enjoy making and let the views come later, because eventually people will find that passion that you have for the content. If you're not actually passionate about making videos, don't do it. It's not worth it. Trust me, don't waste your time. Don't waste everybody's time. Now, I'm probably going to make this a sub-series. We'll probably do how to get your first 10,000, 100,000, a million. And I mean, there's going to be specific things that we talk about in those videos. But for this one, we're trying to get to 1,000 subs in a 2020 saturated YouTube market that it is so hard to get your head above water. Everybody's done it. Everybody's done it 100 different ways. It's hard. It's super hard, and you have to be dedicated to the craft and understand that it's going to take time. So let's talk about promotion. Twitter and Instagram, they are excellent for new creators. Twitter can be a bit of a pain to grow an audience, but with Instagram, it's pretty forgiving to smaller accounts thanks to the hashtag system. Instagram has such a massive user base that if you can figure out how to use the tags to your advantage, you can actually grab a following rather quickly and direct them to their YouTube channel. Then, once people are on your YouTube and Instagram, you can use that to direct them to Twitter, which you can use as your communication hub. It's this ecosystem that you can just get flowing with your content. Now, don't expect to get a lot of followers on Twitter on its own. Twitter just isn't really a platform where that happens anymore. It's a place for your existing audience to congregate, if that makes any sense to you guys. But it's still super important for maintaining a brand. Cross-promotion is really important when you just start out because of how hard YouTube can be on new channels. I mean, you are at the algorithm's you're at its mercy. You are. You're not going to get a lot of growth on YouTube alone when you first start out. So you want to cast the widest possible net in terms of potential viewers and platforms. Twitter, Instagram, heck, if you want to dive into Facebook, dive into Facebook. Now, let's talk about the actual content itself for a minute here. It is super important that you have good equipment. I'm not trying to plug any sponsors I have, but just have good equipment. I'm not saying you have to get a $500 mic. But if you're using a headset or a laptop mic, people are going to click right off you. They're not going to take you serious anymore. This is not 2012. Nobody wants to listen to headset mics in 2020. Thankfully, it's also really easy to get a good sounding USB mic on Amazon for super cheap. The same goes for editing. You need to make it look like you actually know what you're doing. If you're just going and doing generic captions with stock sound effects and transitions, people are going to click off because they've seen this a million times over and it just makes you look unoriginal. Okay? I'm just, don't shoot the messenger. I'm just telling you what I know. Find an editing style that's clean, visually appealing. It doesn't have to be super fancy or anything like that, but it needs to look clean, precise, and at least have somewhat of a professional vibe. Most of what I'm saying here can be done on a free editing software. It really can. If you're on a budget, you can do it. It's tougher, but you can do it. If you have the money to spare, look into good editing software for the style of content that you're doing. If you want to add animations and a whole bunch of layers to the video, you're probably going to have to pay up a bit for something fancier. But if you're just wanting to do something very simple like commentaries or stream highlights, you can totally get by with something like iMovie or Windows Movie Maker. I know, it's not super cool. I get it. It's not cool to use free editing software like that, but you can make it work and they won't know what you used. I know plenty of big YouTubers who used free editing software for the longest time simply because the content they were making didn't really demand a lot of fancy editing. It all comes down to what you want from your content and how well you can make it work with the tools you've got. So make sure your voice sounds good, and please Make sure you're uploading in 1080p at least. I mean, please. But for the actual editing, you don't have to splurge on a program unless you really want to. And we'll talk about computer breakdowns and what kind of equipment you need on the bigger level when we go into the other video. So the last thing I want to talk today about is the upload consistency. And this is another topic where you'll get different answers depending on who you ask. And I know people who upload multiple times a day and they swear that's the key to success. But then we also know there are plenty of successful YouTubers who go days or even weeks without uploading and they're still perfectly fine. So honestly, your upload consistency depends on how well your videos get picked up in the algorithm, but that's something you shouldn't even be thinking about right now until you're making money from this stuff. Don't even think about the algorithm. If you just started out and you want to grow, I would suggest trying to upload at least 4 times a week. If you can swing daily uploads without sacrificing your content's quality, definitely do that. But there is a fine balance there. The more you upload, the less time you're going to have to make new videos. And that often leads to rushing your existing content, and that is what you don't want to do. And you also have to talk about YouTube's notification system. There's secrets to that too, which we'll get into in further videos. You never know when somebody is going to be seeing you for the first time. So you want every single video to be as good as it possibly can. Find a balance. If you're not making money, it's okay. But you also need to be getting consistent so you can get pushed by the YouTube algorithm and your viewers can start expecting that regular content from you. The balance is different for everybody, but keep an eye on it. Make sure no matter what video somebody sees of you first, it is going to be a good representation of your brand and what you bring to the table. And I'll tell you right now, I used to upload 2 to 3 times a day. And then I took a step back and went to 1 time a day, which it's hard to do because sometimes you think you just have to have that quantity. But in my case, I actually grew more with less content. So it all depends. And there you have it, my friends. Those are some tips to help you get your first 1,000 subs on YouTube as a gaming channel. If you guys have comments, let me know. I'll respond to as many as I can. If you guys want to see how to get your first 10,000 or 100,000 or even 1,000,000, we can go super, super in depth on those. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you found this any type of informative, make sure you share it and drop a like. I'll see you soon.